All right. Good evening, everyone. My name is Herschel Parikh, and I'm one of the founders of TuvaLabs. And as a country, the United States is in the middle of a math education crisis. Nearly 6 out of every 10 fourth graders and nearly 5 out of every 8th grader in our country is behind in math. Now, let me put that in perspective here. There's about 100 of us in the room, and that statistic suggests that 60 of us suck at math. And that is a crisis. How do we solve this crisis? What's the solution? And it turns out that it's a fairly systemic problem. There's a lot of different layers to it. But one thing is glaringly obvious. Math is boring. And our students find it completely irrelevant, completely unengaging, and meaningless. And hence, they're not motivated to learn math. And that's the problem we're aiming to solve. So let me take you back to middle school, all right? So come back to middle school with me, and we'll see how TuvaLabs aims to solve the problem by connecting the real world to math and making it so that it's interesting to each individual child by connecting it to their interests, their passions, and hobbies. So how does math relate to what they do outside of school? So let's go back to middle school. So I'm a teacher. I log into TuvaLabs, and as soon as I log in, I'm able to log into my dashboard. One of the basic features that a teacher wants to do is able to create homework assignments. So on TuvaLabs, I go to my classroom, my dashboard classroom, and I create an assignment on ratios for my sixth grade class. And I create the assignment for my entire class on ratios, 2 units, give it a start date, so give it today, it's due by tomorrow night. And you guys recall and having fond memories yet? And I create the assignment. So far, the teacher has done nothing different than what she would do in a typical classroom, in a traditional classroom. But with TuvaLabs, now we have Corey sitting over here who logs in for his homework. And as soon as Corey logs in, the first aspect is not so much, here's the math. The first aspect is, what do you like? What are you interested in? What are your passions? And it turns out Corey's a big fan of baseball, and particularly he loves the Yankees and the Oakland A's. In terms of food, turns out Corey's a big fan of Italian food. So we're gonna pick Italian here. And so what we have done is just created a simple profile of what Corey really enjoys. And now, as Corey sets off to do his assignment that I've assigned, the entire context of learning the ratios is in the topics that he's really interested in. And this is individualized for each student. So when Corey begins the assignment, it's not so much, here's the boring math problem from the back of your textbook. It's about, here's the Yankees playing yesterday, and now solve math problems and learn math topics around the Yankees today. So it's dynamic. It's relevant to you and your interests, your passions, what you find really exciting in your life outside of school. And this can be truly personalized for each individual student, like the 100 of us that are in the room. So this gives you a brief taste of TuvaLabs in terms of what we're able to do to engage a child in their math learning. At Project Liberty, one of the hypotheses that we had was that this doesn't have to be confined to the four walls of the classroom. It can happen as you're reading your news, or it can happen while you're watching your favorite game. And that's what we've been able to build in collaboration with Philly Daily News. So on the Daily News, this is a recently launched website, beautiful website, and here's your typical article on the Phillies from the game last night or from the season. And as you go on and read the article, both as a father or as a son, or anybody else within the family, towards the bottom, we take what the article is about and embed within it opportunities to learn math. So here you see what we call digital learning cards. So these are learning cards that are embedded within the news article that you can solve that are related to the story that you're reading. And this is just one additional way that kids can engage in their math learning while they're reading the news, while they're reading about their favorite high school football team, or what have you. And this just gives you a small preview of the kind of learning that can happen when it is truly personalized and related to what an individual truly enjoys in their life, and not something that has to be confined to your typical textbook that's been going on for decades now. So I'll wrap that up here. We're TuvaLabs. Here's our details. And I'd love to answer any questions that you might have. Right, so we are specifically focused on communities that are highly economically disadvantaged. We're working in Camden, in North Philly, in the Bronx, East Brooklyn, Queens. And there, having access to laptops and internet is an issue. What we are finding is that if we're able to create a similar environment on an iPod and a smartphone, then we're able to get to them easier. So that's part of what our roadmap is for the summer, is to build a similar environment for learning on the phone. Right, so the question is, how do we fit into the standardized testing environment? We're aligned to what's called the Common Core Standards, which are being adopted by 45 states across the country. So by engaging in our tool, the students are actually learning what they're supposed to learn as part of the curriculum. And just for the record, we're focused on middle school right now, grades 6, 7, 8. Plenty of research has shown that if you lose a child in middle school in terms of math, it's nearly impossible for them to get back up in high school and get back to proficiency. So middle school is kind of the big crutch when it comes to math education. Yeah, so we've got it's a good point. And the goal is to provide opportunities to learn wherever they interact. That includes videos, that includes on their mobile phone, maybe potentially on Twitter, on Facebook. So the notion of the article integration is just a first taste of how this learning can take place outside of the classroom environment. But yeah, video is, we're working potentially with a partner on that, still in the works. So what's our business model, I suppose? It's a good question. And we're working with schools right now. We're piloting our product with, as I said, 5 schools between here in Philadelphia and New York City. And the point of the pilot is to really focus on polishing up our product, our pedagogy, and all of that. And our long-term business strategies is to be able to offer to both the school market and the B2C parent market, especially in the mobile space. So the need is for both, and there is appetite for engaging content and engaging products in both environments. So initially focusing on schools, but as soon as we have our mobile app up and ready to go, we hope to be able to get in front of families and parents as well. Right, so yeah, that's a good point. Again, it's about figuring out what the child is interested in. There's, you know, if you go to a Citizens Bank Park right now, there's going to be hundreds of kids who are big fans of baseball, of Jimmy Rollins. Maybe for ice cream too. And hey, we can take the ice cream and turn that into math content as well. So the idea still stands. But no, the idea, you know, what we're able to do is take any opportunity, any data that's out there, whether it's in the form of a Philly scorecard or in the form of an ice cream recipe or in form of their high school football team, and transform it into content. So it's whatever you like, just tell us and we'll be able to cater the learning to your interest. Right, so crowdsourcing the content, especially in the education space, it's hard to, there's certainly value there, but I don't think we can build a business on it. I think you have to, there's two parts to the answer. The first one is that it's hard to monetize that content. And the second one is that for a lot of teachers, they don't want to go through the pain and the time to actually create their own content. So having something readily available adds a lot of value. Our goal is that as soon as we build out the tools in a more robust way, right now it's fairly internal in terms of content creation. Once it's more robust by September of this school year, the new school year, we'll then open it up for teachers to create their own content as well on top of what we already provide them.
Hold on. Why don't we give someone else an opportunity to ask?
No, we're creating our content. We're creating content dynamically as the world is unfolding around us. So tonight, for example, as soon as the Phillies game ends, there will be content available for students to consume tomorrow. No, we have, it's both. There's a human intervention to prepare the content, but then we have built an engine that kind of just does the rest of the work, the heavy lifting. So there's about, I'd probably say 15% human intervention and 85% automatically done. We base it on student surveys. So we conduct surveys of students. We find out what's in the trend, what's hot with them, and we kind of take it from there. But you know, pop culture is usually a good bet. Music, movies, sports, concerts, all of that. Yeah. As I said, it's a very system-wide issue in terms of funding, in terms of approaches. What we have seen with our pilots right now is we have schools paying for our pilots because our product doesn't replace the teacher. It supplements their work. It helps them create content. It helps them customize it. So teachers welcome us with open arms, and that's helpful. In terms of tutoring services, that's an area that I think there is potential, and it's just a market that we haven't tapped into yet that we might down the line.
One last question. How can the Philly Tech community help you out?
Yeah, if you're a parent, I'd love to talk to you, so please find me while I'm here. If you are a teacher, a math teacher, or if you know teachers, please do let us know as well. We'd love to get ourselves in front of the education community to get feedback. So if you're a parent or a teacher, come get us. And that's about it.
Awesome. Give these guys a round of applause.